video, guys. And today I'm going to be sharing some good and bad news. So I'm going to tell you the bad news. I am leaving gymnastics. I'm going to be telling you some basic information about my gymnastics career, just if you're wondering and like, yeah. So I started at the age of 2.5 and I'll be finishing at the age of 16 and a half. So that means I've done it for 14 years. That is a long time, that's basically my whole life. So the reason why I started gymnastics is that when I was little, I constantly ran everywhere. I was so energetic. So then my mum decided to get me into Pacers Gymnastics Club, and it started from there. So at 5 years old, I got asked to go into the squad. I'm not sure how many hours I did, but I think it was like 15 to 18. But then when I was age 13 to 15, I was doing around 20 hours a week. So I've had a few coaches over the years, starting off with Lacra, Charlie, Ovi, Haley, Jenny, Jack, Kathleen, and you know. So the best coach I've had is Charlie, as she's made me the gymnast, and without her, none of this would have happened. We've been through so much together, and I've had the best part of my career with her. Puts me on to the next thing I'm going to be talking about. So the next thing I'm going to say is more information about my career overall. So my favourite part in gymnastics is when I went on all of the pieces in Challenge Cup and I managed to finish 9th overall out of 51 gymnasts. But out of all the routines, the best part is when I landed on bars and I realised that I finally did a bar routine. I will explain later on with what the problem I had with bars. So the favourite competition I had was Challenge Cup, but also my first national grade when I came 6th. I was clean all around and I wasn't expecting it because I didn't know that I was going to place in national finals. The hardest skill I believe that I tried was a full in back out, which is a full twist in double back, but you do the full twist first and the double back, but you'll see a video right now. This was hard, wasn't that hard, but it's hard to understand as it's quite complicated. Okay, so my favourite skill is a side summit. I think it's because I found it easy to learn. I really enjoyed performing the skill. And I had no fear. So this leads me on to my least favourite skill, which is a flick flick. I know it's simple, but when I was younger, I had a lot of problems. That included stropping, crying, cuts, maybe splitting the beam, and even being sent home. And yeah, I was not very good. I think it was a scary skill for me, and I hated it as we had to do it for complex, so like, every other day, and if we didn't have it completed, then we wouldn't do other skills, so that really frustrated me. So here are some pictures of myself and my group in 2009 when I was 8 years old. I think this was my first grade. When I was little, I didn't really place that high because I wasn't really that talented, but then throughout the years I've worked hard to achieve some of the results, but because I've had injury, it's made me fall. So, just so you know, fun fact of the day of my gymnastics career is my first ever competition I competed in, I came last. Yeah, just shows that I was bad. So I've competed in many competitions over the years. The one that I'm going to be showing you is regionals. This is when I was actually improving and actually got on the podium. This was in 2010. And then the next comps I'm going to be showing you is in 2012, which is Kent, when I got my first ever trophy. And regionals. Always in regionals, I've always... Oh, always get second place, which really annoyed me, but I just kept mucking up because of my nerves. I'm going to be showing you some competition pictures and competition videos. Enjoy! Okay, let's talk about English. Well, English. So, I started off really good, stuck it, and I got exactly the same score as my best friend. Just amazing. And then bars came. Yeah, I didn't even kick hard enough on my full turn, and I didn't go over. And then I got back on, and then I nearly didn't get over on my long swing, so I had to bend my legs. Great. Then I went on to beam. I missed all my connections and I think I fell off once or twice. Anyway, yeah. Then I went on to, what's the other pieces? Floor. I did a good double back, stuck it. And then I went out the floor on both tumbles and I think I fell over. No, I didn't. Maybe I did, but okay. So gymnastics has come with many struggles. The main struggle that I've had is my full turn on bars. The skill was a nightmare for me. I went to so many competitions, not being able to go over the bar, and I kept falling off, keep trying and trying, and yeah, another competition, I fell off again. And then finally, the biggest comp I've ever done came, and I done it! The amount of relief I had, I was so happy, and this is the best moment I've had in my career. It was just, because like before, my training was going so bad, I kept falling off, I was like, right, I need to do this. Like, all my competitions, I've not fallen, I've not gotten over. This time, I'm going to get over. And I did, and I was so happy. Portugal. This is when we went for a week every year for 3 years. And we had a holiday slash training session. So you'd do 2 training sessions a day. And then in between them, you'd have like pool time. And then in the evenings, you get to chill out. And it was a really nice time. I loved Portugal so much. The first 2 years were the best. But the last year, I didn't really like, as I was injured again. As I'll talk about that in a minute. Here are some clips at Portugal. Lauren, say hello.
Hi.
Say hello. Emily, say hello. Hello. Emily, say hello.
You're the only one that will get away with it.
No, he's not.
It's so awkward. Is that it?
Our last session. It's our last session today. So, yeah. But I've had a really good session today. Oh, what's happening? Oh, t-shirts. Oh, you're having the meat lovers. Hey guys.
We're in his hut. Mary's guitar.
Injuries. This is the main reason why I'm going to give up gymnastics. I hate injuries with a passion. Over my career, I've had so many, from minor ones to major ones, and even needing an operation. So when I was little, I had knee problems. This was because I had a weak bum. Then I split my head open on a table on the vault. Then I had foot injuries. I don't really know what caused it, but maybe I just kept landing short. Then one day I looked here at the ankle bone, and it was like blue, purple, pink, red, even a little bit of turquoise. So I sat out and got ice. So that day, my mum decided to take me to hospital and made sure that there wasn't a problem. Then we found out it was a hairline fracture. When I remember is when I was getting my cast and I was crying so much because couple weeks after was my first ever challenge cup, and that was really big for me. And then 2 days later, my sister broke her arm, and then, oh my god, my mum had to like look after me in the car, and then my sister in like casting her arm. It was just crazy. Okay, so the next major injury I had was that I broke my toe. I was doing long swings on the bar, well, it's actually giant, just the basic skill, and I whacked my toe on the bottom bar, like so hard, I broke it. It was so disgusting. I remember it being bruised, and I couldn't put pressure on it, so I had to have crutches. So the next incident is that I pulled most of the ligaments in my knee. So the week before competition, I was on bars. I had to do a correction on my bar dismount, and I opened out too early. So, well, yeah, I landed on a really bad straight leg, and I remember getting carried out as I couldn't put pressure on my leg. That night, it was the worst sleep ever. I don't really have any pictures of this injury, so you'll just have to see my face. And my final injury, well, hopefully my final injury ever, but yeah, fingers crossed it's my final injury. So was my wrist. This injury has made me been out of gym for a whole year. And whilst I've been doing it, I've been trying a new sport. I've been doing a lot of squats in weightlifting, and people have been telling me that I'm very strong. People have been telling me that I'm really strong and that I had a guys and techniques, and I found it easy, and apparently people take a long time to learn it, and I just got it straight away and I loved it. So I think maybe I will be doing weightlifting. These are the gymnasts that I've met, and some of the pictures with James and Courtney. So what's next? So like I said earlier, I will be moving on to a new chapter, and I will be doing weightlifting. Fingers crossed I can achieve more than I did in gymnastics, and I will get no injuries. Touch wood. Good. So here are some clips. So this is the last thing I'll be saying. I would like to say that the only reason why I've made this video is so I can look back at it when I'm older. I'm not doing this to show off or boast or anything. I just want to have it as a memory so I can look back when I'm older, yeah, basically. So I'd just like to thank all my coaches, especially Charlie and my family, who have spent so much time driving me to gym, using their free time for competitions, and just packing up with me. And the best part of doing gym is that I made my lifelong friend. And my best friend!
Me?
No, Rachel. And thank you to her for helping me and believing in me. I'm going to be doing a gymnastics edit now of all my career and stuff. But I'd like to say thank you. Bye, gymnastics.
What?
Bye, gymnastics.
Should I do it again?
No, just be like, I'm really sad.
I'm not sad.
Oh,
Josie, Griffiths. Yay!